Welcome to Bangkok, 47. Ken Morgan has booked the Queen Suite, but has yet to check in. You will find him in and around the restaurant. Oddly enough, Jordan Cross seems completely unaware of his presence. Cross and the class have set up a recording studio in the Emperor's Suite on the third floor. Private security around Cross and his entourage is highly capable. Still, I'm sure you can find your way into his inner circle. After all, today is Jordan Cross's 27th birthday. The age when rock stars die. Good luck, 47.
All right there?
Welcome to the Hidden Pan Hotel. Yes. What a place you have here. Hello there.
Where have you been the last couple of months?
In Switzerland, sweating atoms.
Okay, good answer. Anyway, Eugene Cobb was director of this big old New York bank. Then a while back, his private jet disappeared over the Pacific.
Oh, storm?
No, it was a beautiful day. But according to FAA, there was a mysterious radar malfunction and the plane was hundreds of miles off course. And now, they say the black box is missing.
All of which has gone considerably enough out of the woodwork.
The Illuminati guy as well.
Yeah, something like that. I think the professor had him killed. Guy called Famine? I don't know. He looks like he's got something to hide.
Hey,
so Kruger's shaving his head to prove he's more than just his hair? He just doesn't give a shit.
Set those haters straight, huh?
Okay, I really don't.
You just need to talk to someone. Just get that crazy shit out of your head, okay?
Shit.
You have no right to talk to me like that. I'm in a quiet case. Don't fight me, acquire some taste.
Good to see you.
Checking in. Name's Tobias Reber.
Thank you so much, sir. Here's your key card. Welcome to the Himapan Hotel.
Welcome to the Himapan Hotel. Please follow me. I hope you'll enjoy your stay.
Lead the way.
Sir, please. This way.
Welcome to the Himapan Hotel, sir. Please let me know if you need anything.
I don't want to spoil the party, but then I would own my business.
Sir?
Great. Now they're not even letting you get in.
Sir, please follow me. Let me show you to your room.
Yeah, the cross beam. I mean, it's like they're taking over the place, room by room. As if the noise wasn't enough.
It's getting rude. People pay good money to stay here.
The owner doesn't give a shit.
This is your room, sir. I hope it's to your liking. But please, don't hesitate to let us know if there's anything you need.
Any points?
that is not properly made. See that it's done right away.
Reception, sir?
Ah, yes. I am here to make the bed for you. I am very sorry about the inconvenience, sir.
Hurry up, get cracking.
Have a great day, man.
Straighten up! Don't slouch!
How's it going?
Is that her? Heidi?
don't you think?
Mm. Well said.
I don't think I could do this much more. Don't forget to smile.
Okay, let me tell you this one then. I once installed an air horn under my colleague's chair. It scared the living crap out of him.
I'm not Paul Desmond, I know who I am. Washed up sitcom star. How? It suits me.
Who's the jittery guy over there? Looks like another one of those rock stars.
That's Abel Da Silva. He's only one of the most awesome drummers on the New York indie scene. He was in Death and Taxes.
We're in the middle of a discussion here. So unless you have something to contribute, please get the hell out of here.
He was in Death and Taxes and Flat Earth Society.
Yeah, I like Top 40.
Anyway, Da Silva's filling in for the drummer in Jordan Cross's band who quit yesterday. The record label flew him in, and I took him up to the restaurant lounge. Oh, Miss Barrett, the manager, she's gonna come get him soon.
Gee, I guess I should get his autograph.
You don't...
Interesting. The class's regular drummer unexpectedly quit the band, and the record label has flown in a replacement. Upcoming indie drummer Abel Da Silva, who is currently waiting in the restaurant lounge. Better yet...
You deserve his autograph. You deserve poop in a bag.
Good day to you, sir.
Yes, I am well aware that the cake topper is missing. Can't it wait? We're tremendously busy here. It's only numbers. I'm sure Jordan Cross doesn't need a cake to remind him how old he is. Thomas Cross. The cake was his idea. Very well. I have one of my...
More curry with fresh curry. As soon as possible, English jacket.
Hey, what's up with you?
Today is Jordan Cross's birthday, and manager Dexie Barrett has prepared a small surprise party for him. The kitchen has baked a special vegan cake to suit his rock star tastes.
The octopus, we nearly done.
Thank you.
Understood, Chef.
Let's step up!
Huh. I didn't like the sound of that. Not bad.
Well, we need the three dishes for table four out now.
I'm on it, Chef.
Time to step it up. Let's get this service in gear.
Hey, you better not be one of them drug fiends looking to sell your perfectly formed ass for a fix of hash.
How's the fish? Is it good to go?
Yes,
I got
sir.
A new order. They're expecting right away. Chop, chop.
Thank you. The service has just been exquisite.
Even if they're washing dishes or shining shoes.
Good day to you, sir.
Rich. Buddy. Old man Cross is super rich.
Oh, Wow.
Cross is no Thomas Wayne.
Say what?
Hi, Chef.
Old manipulative bastard. And Jordan has spent a
life. Hey, could you get me a snack?
Yo, Chef.
Good. Cross will be here shortly. And I dare say he's in for a surprise.
My God!
dicey.
So who's...
Yeah, we're just about ready over here. So bring on the birthday boy. Yeah. We know the words.
Okay, yeah. See you in a bit. Okay, guys. Jordan's on his way down. So get into position and, you know, fire up those vocal cords, okay?
Okay, so I'll see the lead. You chaps better back me up. Don't just smile for words. I'll know if you do. This better improve the mood around here. What kind of tension will the knife?
Why'd I have to be vegan? Okay, everyone, focus. Let's show Jordan how much we care.
What are we doing here?
We wish you a happy birthday, darling.
We wish you an awesome year. We wish that to you, Jordan. Happy birthday.
Oh, well, shit, fellas. Look, I mean, that's pretty decent of you.
Don't mention it, darling. Have a taste. It's vegan. Yum.
Oh, vegan, huh? All right. You guys went through a lot of trouble, huh?
Oh, no. It wasn't us. Your father ordered it.
My father?
Oh, yeah. He was real particular. I mean, everything had to be just right for his son's big day, huh?
Oh, did he now? It's perfect, yeah.
What an asshole!
Okay, thanks for doing this, guys, but why don't we give Jordan a little bit of space now, okay?
Way to go, Colin. Smooth as always.
Darling.
He sent me a cake, Dexie. A cake!
I know, but maybe your father is a complicated man. Maybe this is... This is his way of reaching out and trying to...
Oh, that asshole never reached for anything but his wallet. Right? I'll tell you what this is. This is one giant frosting-covered fuck you. This is Thomas Cross saying, I own you, bitch. He's saying that no matter where I go or what I do, I will always screw up and need him to bail me out.
That's an awful lot to read into a cake.
Oh, you don't know him, Dex. And I pray you don't get to.
I'll give you a moment, darling.
Target down. Next up, Ken Morgan.
Hello there.
Hold on. Okay. All kitchen staff greenlit. Sir, if you want to proceed, I'm going to have to do a quick routine check.
Just relax. You'll be on your way in a sec. Thank you. Have a good one, sir.
guy? I mean, what's his problem?
Which camp are you in? Accident or murder?
What? Branson MD2?
Yep. Also known as Old Sparky. Almost bankrupted Branson Tech back in the day.
Yeah, well, why would Wes want to use a mic with a notorious production error?
Wes is uncompromising.
Always chasing that perfect sound. He once spent 6 days tweaking the spring reverb for Noel Wagner's Rickleback until Noel had a nervous breakdown and knocked Wes out cold with a frying pan. And this other time, Wes locked himself in the studio with a loaded revolver, threatened to shoot anyone from the artist.
Doesn't seem fair, you know, someone like Cross to have that much money and talent.
Yeah, maybe. But Thomas Cross still used his
media. Anyway.
Really?
That was a little bit rude.
Yeah, good job, Chef.
Well, you're no quitter. I've got to give you that.
Look, I can fix this. I'm homing in on the problem. I just gotta... Damn it!
Yeah. Are you sure you don't want a ride home?
It's not about that. Hey, what are we doing? There's this guest. Big shot lawyer fella up in the Queen Suite. He's offered to buy it. This piece of crap for, like, an obscene amount of money. I just gotta get the engine running.
A guest wants to buy your crummy old tuk-tuk.
According to the hotel gardener, Ken Morgan wants to purchase his aging tuk-tuk as a souvenir. Unfortunately for him, he can't get the engine working. Well...
Tourists, right? They just love authenticity. I don't know, the guy wants to use it as a golf cart at his Hampton Country Club or whatever. Be my guest.
Well, I guess I can stick around for a bit. You know, for more.
Thanks. That's all nice. Huh? Who says he?
God damn it. Why won't you work? Great. Someone else's headache, then.
Well, that's great.
Great. Glad. You know, we should hang out more.
Oh, jeez.
Hey! Release!
So, what's for dinner?
I got it covered.
Okay, sorry, that was lame.
Even at very large doses.
Hi, Chef.
I hope it wasn't disgusting.
No, it's just stupid. Someone left their wallet in their pockets.
Years. Cross Holding owns a swath of real estate in the Bangkok area. The Hemipen is only one of them.
I thought Thomas Cross was a media mogul.
Ah, these multinationals like to branch out. Investment, prestige. They own a football team, I think. Besides, the way I hear it, Thomas Cross is a total wreck. It's like impossible to die, so you have to get through.
Uh-huh. According to the hotel manager's memo, drunken members of Jordan Cross's sound crew broke into the Queen Suite last night and trashed the place. Housekeeping is...
Damn it. Why won't you work?
Good show, 47. It's time to close the deal.
Good luck in the kitchen.
This looks interesting.
Pork curry with fresh cardamom, rude English jackass and
what? Hey, look, what you're doing is weird. We don't cotton to weirdness around here.
Ken Morgan, has a message come through for me yet?
Hold on. No,
still nothing. Frightfully sorry, Mr. Morgan.
This doesn't bode well. When can I have my suite?
Housekeeping is just adding the finishing touches.
Hey, it won't stop that. Now, sir. Just stop.
Yeah. It's not like I haven't done anything.
Hi, Chef.
Are you with your facial?
Keith McKenzie, U.S. Attorney's Office, South District.
Keith?
I saw you at the Chelsea Whitmore trial. Your strategy was the brassiest thing I've ever seen. The girl burned a homeless man alive and framed her cheerleading rival, and you got her off on affluenza charges? Stroke of genius, sir.
I see. You're, not gonna give me the speech about how I'm part of the problem? About how you will never embrace the private sector because you're fighting the good fight. And justice is more important than money.
Shit, no. The U.S. Attorney's Office is just a stepping stone to me. You don't buy a place in the Hamptons on a state salary.
Keith, give my office a call. Morgan, Yates & Co. We may have something for you.
Thank you, sir. Will do.
Excuse me, Mr. Morgan, sir?
Yes. Ah, the tuk-tuk fellow. Did you manage to fix the engine?
Yes, sir. She spins like a kitten.
All right. Lead the way.
Those little hors d'oeuvres, so cute and tasty.
I get hungry when I see you.
Thank you.
Hi, Chef.
All right, there she is. go ahead, Mr. Morgan. Please, you do the honors.
Jesus!
Both targets down. Now head towards an exit.
What's up in the kitchen?
Sir, you are... trespassing. Sir, are you hearing impaired?
What?
What's cooking?
So, I want to get that package on the web, but reception says one of our guys picked it up an hour ago.
Must have been Julian.
body of billionaire media mogul Thomas Cross was discovered earlier this evening, slain by multiple gunshot wounds. Cross was scandalously kidnapped this morning at the funeral of his only son, acclaimed rock musician Jordan Cross. A notorious recluse, Thomas Cross has not left the private life in years, and authorities are now looking into a connection between the two deaths.
Cross had billions in hidden offshore accounts, all stripped clean within hours of the kidnapping. Someone wanted the son dead to lure out the father. Someone smart enough to stay in the shadows while we did the wet work and the Highmores picked up the check.
A shadow client. Someone got rich. The contract was just. That was a sound problem.
I know you don't care about politics, 47. But ICA is neutral, always has been. Can't allow ourselves to be manipulated. Besides...
It's happened before.
Italy. Morocco. Paris. All our clients got their intel the same way. Anonymous tips from a hidden source. Each contract perfectly legit. Yet part of a grander design.
I don't see the pattern.
Somebody does. The board has asked us to chase down this shadow client, and our analysts are closing in as we speak.
I know that tone.
Someone's playing a game, 47. The question is... Against whom?